what you see. Be like a battery, I'm staying charged on my feet. I'm like a factory, dropping lines like an assembly. I'm staying on point. Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome to Zuka Tube, and today we're going to be reviewing a movie called Clerks 3. This is obviously the third movie in the series, and this just came out September 13th of 2022. And here's a little summary we got. After suffering a massive heart attack, Randall enlists friends and fellow clerks Dante, Elias, Jay, and Silent Bob to help him make a movie about life at the Quick Stop. And yeah, so we'll go through the summary. I'll play a few clips during my review, and then I'll do a little spoiler section at the end after the review. Now, with that being said, let's play this trailer. Ah, that all looks familiar.
That's how we did it in the 90s, son!
I can't catch my breath, man.
Really? Should I try mouth stuff?
What is this, a Tinder date? Get off of me. Oh, shit.
Mr. Dante! I need an ambulance at the Quick Stop!
Collapses.
Save my life, man. Wish I had a life worth saving.
What are you talking about?
Sit around and watch the same movies over and over.
I always thought you could have made a cool
movie. He had a heart attack.
You're right.
That
I'm living on borrowed time.
Familiar.
No more watching movies. I'm gonna make a movie!
What's the movie gonna be about?
It's about him working here.
Meta. Everything in the script is something either me Meta, or someone man. I know said.
I'm not even supposed to be here today! Maybe Jay and Silent Bob could be characters.
Jay and Silent Bob are like C-3PO and R2-D2. They've been here since the first movie, which was the last time they were cool. But they've been with the franchise so long, they still give them cameos and put them on the lunch boxes.
Snoochie Boochies, please tell me!
Snoochie Boochies.
They believe in you.
Did you put in that stuff you used to say about the Death Star contractors?
Get sued by Disney? No way.
Get sued by Disney?
Your pants.
A lot of people are in this film.
What the hell is this?
I added a scene where you get shot.
I'm not letting you kill me off in the third act. What if there's a sequel?
A sequel? What am I, a hack?
A lot of those, you know.
I think it needs more weed.
Jokes breaking the fourth wall. All right, so that's the trailer. And it's pretty self-explanatory, right? Now, with that being said, now, as a fellow Jersey native and stuff, I grew up watching a lot of the Kevin Smith films, so obviously, I feel always obligated to check out every new film, especially if it's a sequel to something I grew up watching, like Clerks. Later on in life, obviously, you hear Kevin Smith had a heart attack and stuff like that. He went through, and he's still doing his thing, grinding and all that stuff. And I haven't been a real big fan of Kevin Smith or the stuff he's been putting out lately, but obviously I'm a fan of his past stuff, right? That's all very visible here in this film. Like, you know, the whole nod to, you know, him having a heart attack, basically, you know, got to do his thing, make a movie, live for the moment, that whole deal. And then on top of it, while making a sequel, and they're doing it by pretty much making the original film. You know, it's like so meta, man, you know, that whole deal. The one thing I have to say is it's very, if you've seen the Jay and Silent Bob reboot film, it's almost the same idea, you know, but then they take it like another step further. So basically, yeah, Randall, he has a heart attack. He's like, man, I got to get my shit together. I got to make a film about my life. I got to do something with myself. And they tell you that Dante, his wife, Rosaria Dawson, from the previous film, they had like a daughter and they passed away from a drunk driver. They tell you pretty much early on that she's no longer in the picture, right? And they have a lot of the typical comedic banter throughout some stuff. You know, they kind of turn up a notch and throw into other scenarios outside of, like, the Quick Stop in this film, obviously. And I'll show you a little funny clip from when he's in the hospital, you know, when he's having a heart attack.
Well, if you know what's wrong, then I guess I can go home.
Are you the doctor?
I'm the doctor, Dr. Leidenheim. I'll be your savior this evening. I apologize for my wardrobe. I just came from a costume ball.
Listen, Doc, I'm okay. I can't catch my breath.
Shout out to that keynote check.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how bad would you say your pain level is?
My pain level? It's like a negative 3.
Well, you're doing it all wrong. You're supposed to be in a lot of pain when you have a heart attack.
Wait a minute, I had a heart attack?
No, that's not what I said. You misunderstood me.
Oh, thank Christ.
You're having a heart attack right now as we speak. A massive one.
Bam.
So we have to act pretty quickly. I just wish I wasn't so hungover. I'm kidding.
What?
I'm going to go get all glammed up for our big date, and I'll see you in the OR. Look at me.
Uh-huh.
Everything's going to be fine, right?
Good. All right.
Yeah, so they have a lot of, like, random comedic banter like that. And if you notice that the nurse in that is doing a kind of Silent Bob-esque thing where she's there kind of quiet but making expression, that's, I've noticed, is recycled a lot in this film. Like, not only is the typical trope of, we're making a sequel, and oh man, we must be hacks, we're making a sequel, you know, that whole typical thing, they're recycling characters and the way character dynamics work and the way scenes have played out in his previous film throughout everything here. And it's shot well, and there's some, you know, interesting banter back and forth. Like I said, it's got some good comedy notes to it. But with that being said, here's some banter and some little clips here with the character where you'll see, again, that Jay and Silent Bob dynamic almost play out with these characters.
It's going to be about an hour and a half. I hate long movies.
It's about him working here.
Wow, meta. I've never seen a whole movie set in a convenience store before.
Right? Thank you. I'm going to fill the script with all the weird shit me and Dante have ever said or seen around here over the years.
Oh, you should put in that stuff you used to say about the Death Star contractors.
Get sued by Disney? Fuck that. Besides, I want this movie to be about other movies. I want it to be about me. It's my flick, so I want to write about the things that I do. Like how we play hockey on the rooftop. I've never seen that done.
Yeah, like, it's, you know, the same typical banter that they had in the first two films, but mostly centered around the first film, because they're ultimately making a film and they don't know that they're recreating the first film that we've all seen, right? But there is a lot of funny notes, and there are some nice and kind-hearted and like, or warm-hearted moments, right? Once again, a very nostalgic soundtrack going on throughout. You right away some of the songs you'll notice and jam because you remember them from like every other 90s or 2000s film. Not quite obviously what you saw with like the first film where you saw like what was it, like Soul Asylum and Alice in Chains and stuff like that. Overall, I feel like this movie really didn't have to happen. This is kind of a movie specifically for Clerks fans. Like, you're watching it to get the constant nods to the first two films and then ultimately see a funny adaptation, like, you know, weird meta version of like Kevin Smith's story of him making these films almost, and a reflection of him in modern day, I guess. But I it just doesn't really vibe well with me. It doesn't sit that well with me. This one pulled back a little too much and was a little too emotional for me. And with the whole heart attack thing, they really drill that home in this just over and over again. And if you're a Kevin Smith fan and you're a fan of Jay and Silent Bob and Clerks and everything, you'll enjoy seeing all the cameos, the returning actors, and you'll like all the nods and the nostalgia they give you throughout it. My overall rating, I would give this a 6.5 out of 10. It's not anything to go out and see. You know, I would say wait till it comes out on streaming or out for purchase digitally maybe and pick it up. They might have some funny outtakes, bloopers, some random deleted scenes that I would probably enjoy watching, because there is some funny stuff throughout it that I would like to have seen more of, or at least like some stuff turned up a notch for sure. And with that being said, let's go right into the spoiler section.
Spoilers. Spoilers.
All right, so at the end, towards the end, you know, they see everything kind of kicked back and sand get kicked back in Randall's face because, you know, everybody's like, dude, you're still a jerk off. Like, yeah, like we thought, like we feel bad you had a heart attack and shit, but you're an asshole still, whatever. And basically Dante has his big freak out moment and then he himself has a heart attack and then he's in the hospital and it's this whole thing where he finds out that, you know, he gave up, you know, his half of the store to get the money to help him and all this. And it makes him have this like immediate full 180 moment where he changes his emotions. He's like, oh man, that's my best friend. I can't believe he did this for me. I didn't realize that whole thing. And we have a little clip of that playing out and him showing him this film and being like, I didn't know, man, I couldn't have done this without you kind of shit. Yeah, so it's like an emotional moment and then he passes away when Randall survived. And it's kind of like a sad moment because he was just going off on the whole thing on like, you're lucky you fucking survived, dude. Like, I feel dead inside because I lost my family kind of deal. And I had a chance at a life. But then at the end of the day, they're both together and they have each other and they really ultimately to them have no lives anymore, right? I don't know. It was just like overhaul on the heart attack thing and the, you got to live your life and the constant nods to Kevin Smith's personal life. And then on top of it, the constant nostalgia and repeats of the first two films, or mainly the first film, obviously. And I get why, because they're obviously remaking the first film in this, but it just wasn't that enjoyable. It's funny to watch just maybe in your off time to be like, yeah, that was, yeah, I remember that. Oh, yeah, they're doing that. Yep, I remember that. But overall, not for me. Again, I would give this a 6.5 out of 10. That's Clerks 3. Remember, if you get a chance to like, comment, share, subscribe, let me know what you think of this film. Let me know with the stuff they did at the end, the couple little hints they had that they could do a sequel, if you would think it's even worth it. But either way, that's a 6.5 out of 10. Zookatoo. I'm like a factory, dropping lines like an assembly. I'm staying on point, it's my strategy. Feel like they're tracking me. Yo, let me get on one. Not gonna get your tracks up. Homie, can I steal some? Homie, you can't stack up. My brother, can you shout me? You're barking up the wrong tree. My dog, why do you doubt me? Cause you can't do shit without me. For real, like the radio and never play it. But that's cool. The enemy's supposed to hate it.